You know those people who connect with you on LinkedIn and then just immediately send you a spammy sales message of something like, "Hey John, thanks for connecting. Are you open to a mutually beneficial call? Or, if you're like my pal Mr. Jackson, sir, I am professionally Apple Podcast promoters. I would like to promote your podcast show all the time. Sir, do you want to promote your podcast show? Hello, sir." LinkedIn is one of the most powerful tools for businesses right now. Recently, I was approached by a company called Zopto, who makes one of those like LinkedIn prospecting tools, which automate lots of the process of finding people, connecting with them, and yes, sending some of those automated messages. Now, I have always been someone who disagrees with these tools, as I'm always a fan of doing things organically, but I'm also the kind of person who just loves to automate things. For me, my goal is to connect with as many people in the tech space as I can, which then in turn grows my audience, and that's kind of it. And there's a story that I always remember, but I can't remember who told me or who it was about, but it was about a small company that once decided they wanted to win the business of a much larger business. So what they did was they learned the boss's route from his home to the office, back in the days when stalking wasn't a thing, and bought up billboards along their route. So when they did eventually get in touch, the owner of that larger business was just like, "Hey, you guys are everywhere." When in actual fact, the only place they were strategically placed billboards along his way to work. That is my approach. You want to be in the same places where your prospects are hanging out. And right now, because of everybody being stuck at home, that's LinkedIn. It's virtual networking events, it's supporting other businesses, webinars, and just helping each other out. So today I'm going to be testing out Zopto by using these powers for good. Perfectly balanced, as everything should be. First of all, hi, my name is Pete, and I make videos around tech, business, and finance. So if you're looking for reviews on the latest gadgets, interested in using tech to help grow your business, or wanting to be smarter with your money, then please subscribe for more. So let's just bite into this cookie and say that most people do a horrible, horrible job at prospecting with LinkedIn. They'll load up these massive automation tools, chuck in their massive list of prospects, and just let the scale of numbers do their thing. Because even though the mutually beneficial call approach sounds dumb to most of us, it must obviously work. Spam 1,000 people with the message, and if just 1% take you up, then that's 10 new leads for you. Great way to get 10 new leads. Also great way to turn off 990 potential leads. But in this video, I'm gonna flip this approach completely on its head and go against what most marketeers will probably tell you is the right approach. And we're going to be using Zopto to do just that. And whilst you're watching, why not let me know what interesting requests you've had on LinkedIn recently? Yeah, super interested to hear more worse stories than my own. So yeah, let me know in the comments below. So to get started with Zopto, first you will need a LinkedIn Sales Navigator account. I haven't actually had one before, so just sign up for the free trial and remember to cancel within 30 days if you don't want to spend around things like £50 a month. Now I'm going to load up Sales Navigator, search for my niche audience that I'm searching for, and I run an IT coaching business, so I'm going to look for other IT businesses to connect with. Once you have this, then don't go anywhere, stay here, and we're also going to fire up Zopto itself in a new tab. Now, I'm not going to go through the setup process for hooking it into your accounts or anything. They actually cover that as part of their onboarding process, so keep this video snappy and to the point. Head into campaigns, create campaign, give it a name, and then here is where you want to go back to Sales Navigator, copy the URL of the search, and paste it into here. You can then ignore first degree profiles. I'll check the automate data cleansing here, but leave all the others unchecked. Over on schedule, well, I'm gonna leave it all default, so this runs between 9 and 5. And then over on modules here, this is where the clever stuff happens. I'm gonna check profile views because I want this thing to automatically view their profile first. And then I'm gonna cap that at 35 a day. I don't wanna do anything on Twitter. I do want to send them an invite or connection request. Again, 35 a day. I'm not gonna set a delay because I think it's only natural to view someone's profile and then connect with them immediately or then move on and don't connect. I'm gonna use my tech invite, which I actually set up beforehand. Just a short and simple connection message with no personalization because, well, for one, I always get the impression that when they are personalized, it looks so much more automated than ones that aren't. And then number two, some people have really, really weird names on LinkedIn right now. Yes, I'm looking at you, Jerry Williams, CVA, Purple Crystal Ball, Liam Gardner, microphone. And you, Francis West, padlock with a key. If you use first name, last name placeholders when connecting with people, these people are gonna know immediately that you've used an automated bot to connect with them because, well, their invite will say, "Hey, Jerry Williams, CVA, Purple Crystal Ball." Moving on, I'm not gonna send in-mails and I'm also not going to send a sequence, though it is intelligent enough to stop sending further messages if contacts do reply back. I know Zopto will probably shoot me for not using this part, but my personal goals right now are to connect with a lot of people in the tech industry. Not to sell to them, because I don't actually have anything to sell, but I just want to connect with a wider tech audience, see what interesting things people are chatting about, and just chat. No selling, exactly how I like my social networks to be. So I won't be sending a sequence, but with that said, what I will do is show you something else they gave me access to called Hyperize. And this is actually a really, really cool thing. I just can't think of a fun way to use this other than send funny memes to people, which would annoy people. But that's because my goals are just to connect with people and not start this automated conversation today. But this thing here, which I'll bring on screen, allows you to personalize images by bringing in tags from their LinkedIn profile and then embed them in an image, which you can then include within those like automated prospecting messages. Personally for me, this opens up some incredible room for creativity with this prospecting tool. There is some absolutely genius things you could do here. Connect with someone, get chatting, send some funny personalized memes that look like you've actually spent some time creating them, you know, in Photoshop. Something that will really, really connect you with who you're talking to. So as I said, not using this today, but super, super interested to see what people do with this. And that is essentially it. All we do here is let the tool do its job, you know, view profiles, connect with people, and if you choose to, send them a message sequence. So with that said, what did this tool do for me? Well, over the last 7 days, I've added 49 new connections out of 216 invites, so around about 20% result, which is interesting. But for me, I'd just be getting really, really busy with my LinkedIn posts right now, you know, gotta show up to play, right? Loads of good stuff there. What about the bad stuff? Well, getting my nitpick on, I wish you could just click on the, you know, the viewed invites accepted on the dashboard just to see who those people are. Also, and then when you're first entering your LinkedIn credentials or your Twitter credentials, you can't use a password manager and you can't even copy and paste. Minor frustration. Other than this, pricing wise for Zopto, it starts from $160 per month if billed quarterly, which is what I imagine most people will be signing up to, though it can scale hugely for like agencies or much bigger companies where you want to control multiple LinkedIn accounts. And if you use the link in the description below, you'll get 25% off any plan for 3 months, which then brings that price down to around about $120 per month, which is what, £86 per month? Not bad. Overall, if I hadn't sold my business and I was still looking to connect with like local businesses of certain size or verticals or whatever my target market was, then I think I would definitely give something like Zopto a try. Given that we are still locked up and not allowed out of our houses here, LinkedIn is like the breeding ground right now for lead generation if you do it well. And Zopto has features like automatic scaling so that LinkedIn sees it acting more organically than just a bot like spamming messages. And there's also a ton of templates, and they use their knowledge from running over 12,000 campaigns to help you get the best out of the service, which, by the way, is also included too, with unlimited one-to-one email, chat, and phone calls to make sure you're getting the best out of it. So if you want to check it out, click the link in the description below to get 25% off your first 3 months. And don't forget, of course, to like, subscribe to this channel for more, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.